we do basically is after we receive the planning for production, we start with the preparations of the all tobacco types, all the recipe that goes into every cigar brand. So what we do is that we bring all tobacco bales from the warehouse that they have been stored, and also taking the appropriate aging time in order for the tobacco to release the excess ammonia and to get in the condition where the tobacco can be handled easily in order to produce our bunches. And then, of course, roll the cigars. So as here you can see boxes of cedar filled with the tobacco long filler, well prepared in order for us to give appropriate aging time. It means that we keep the tobacco here minimum 3 weeks. So we have enough tobacco from 3 to 4 weeks of production. So the idea is that we have the tobacco in good condition and ready for production, okay? So this is like a holding. We keep here a decent amount of tobacco in order for us to produce our cigars. So all boxes of tobacco are marked with the origin, a cigar code or a tobacco code, the year that the tobacco was grown, and the type of tobacco and the size, also the size of tobacco. In order for us to track the information, we follow a UPC sticker where we just have to scan the bell tag, and immediately we will know what type of tobacco we are carrying in inventory and how many pounds of tobacco we have already processed. Any questions so far? You can open also. This is empty. Money already stored. Manny, what are the tobacco?
Stole all the tobacco.
It's all empty. We are out of inventory. It means that Manny is using all the tobacco that we have in inventory. This is good because we are making cigar. It means that we are making cigar, right? This is mostly piloto cubano volado, especially for Matanudo and Partagas. Here we have some Nicaragua coming from Esteli. Also, this room is controlled by a moisture level in order for us to keep the tobacco in condition. So the wet temperature goes through 73 to 76% of moisture level. Thank you. So this department, we call it the pesada. It means that this is the area where we prepare the recipe. I mean, like the kitchen, where we prepare all tobacco types that go for to produce the cigar. So the idea is that as every cigar has its own recipe, we prepare enough tobacco for 150 cigars. So it means that we weigh and count every leaf that we put in every bag in order for us to maintain the consistency in the amount of tobacco we are putting in every cigar, okay? Also, it's a way for us to know and to track the information as related to spending of tobacco and the year of tobacco, okay? So here we have Mr. Corporano. This is one of our key employees. He has been with us for more than 20 years, okay? So he's a guy that can identify if the tobacco is in good condition or not, by touching it, by smelling it. It's a guy that came to us and say, Yuri, Manny, this tobacco is not appropriate because it's too dry or it's too wet, you need more condition or whatever. So we are filled with people like Corporan that had a lot of knowledge of tobacco.
Thank you, Corporan.
Welcome where the action happens. Here we are at the Galera, Coro de Galera, the area where we produce the best cigar of the world. So we were in team of three people, two rollers and one bunch maker. The idea is that the bunch maker produce enough bunches for the two rollers. She supplies the two rollers in order to make the daily production. So we put together the different type of tobacco in the hand, also making the method of entubado. With this method, we let the air go freely into the channels. So the combustion improves with this method. And also we have a more even burning. So she distributes the tobacco leaves in her hand and put insert the tobacco in the hole in order to push the machine up. And construct the bunches. A little bit of glue, the bunches. This is the bunches without being pressed. Okay? So after this, we insert the bunches in the plastic mold in order for the bunches to be pressed. So when the bunches get pressed, it gets rounded or cylinder. Okay? The bunches needs to be not too tight, not too loose, in order to have a steadily burning, also a good draw and a consistency when you are smoking the cigar. So here we have two steps. The bunches without being pressed, the bunches already pressed, and the third step is the cigar being wrapped. We explained you this morning, in order to get the best flavor out of the wrapper, we cut just a few on the top of the leaf and a little bit more in the bottom of the leaf, because the top part of the wrapper has a better flavor or has more flavor. So what will we do to maintain the quality and to maintain the consistency in the roll? Also, know by touching only the cigar, we guarantee 100% draw of the cigar. So we have this type of machine that we call it the Draw Master, where we test 100% of the bunches before wrapping the cigar, in order for us to make sure that our cigar have a good draw. Okay, so let's go down there to see the process. So here we conclude our draw testing samples, or not a sample, we test 100% of all the bunches that goes to the production. Okay, in order for us to guarantee that our cigar has a good draw, or they draw perfectly. In every galera, we have a station where we conduct the test.
he filled also a paper in order for us to maintain the record of every team of people, in order for us to track the information, either if the bunches is good or is bad. But normally, we are approaching 99% of good bunches. The cigar production area of La Gloria Cubana. Here we produce La Gloria Cubana cigars, Series R, Rico Habano, and Artesano de Tabaquero. Okay? Why we keep it separate? Why they using a different shirt? Because we want, as I told you, to keep the identity of every cigar product. Okay? When you come to me and say, Yuri, where are you rolling La Gloria Cubana cigar? Okay. I bring you here. This is all La Gloria Cubana. Okay? Bigger cigar size, stronger blends, I mean more label cigar. That's why here we were in pairs of two people. One watchmaker and one roller. Because it's a more label and also bigger vintage. Okay? This is like a artisanos tabaqueros guys.
Artesanos tabaqueros.
Speed up the process in order for us to maintain the quality, because it's not the same when you produce 300 cigars than you produce 500. When you produce 500, you have to speed up the process when you make more mistakes. Okay?
I have a question. I've noticed that in other factories I've been at, a lot of times the rollers will be smoking cigars. I haven't seen anybody rolling or bunching cigars smoking. Do you guys not typically let them do that,
because,
or is that just
because of the insurance issues? We are not allowed.
Ah, I see.
Allow
I
them
see.
To smoke in the cigar floor.
Okay? Oh, okay. Okay.
But every week we give all cigar makers few cigars in order for them to take home and smoke cigars. In the past, we used to smoke, but we are not allowed anymore.
Now, insurance just ruins everything,
insurance.
Doesn't it?
Yes, correct. So this is the inspection area where we bring all cigars being produced the previous day. So here we have all cigars that were produced last Friday, because yesterday was a holiday. So here we have, as a supervisor, Estela Espinal. She's a key instrumenter for us in order to maintain the quality and the consistency of our product. She has been with us for more than 35 years, actually. And she knows every piece of tobacco, every piece of wrapper, every piece of quality of our cigar. Also, she's a person that is adapted to the changes. Even though she's a little bit old, she adapted very well to the changes, to the new changes, which is wonderful. So we appreciate a lot the hard work of Stella. So what we do basically here is we bring all the wheels of cigars. In order for us to untie the wheel and inspect them by touching the bunches, also by seeing the wrapper, how many laps the cigar has, if it has a round head, if the wrapper is well straight, it doesn't have big veins near the head, and also if the tobacco, if the wrapper leaf is not broken. But also we pass it to the ring gauge. We pass it to the ring gauge and measure the size of the cigar. in order for us to keep the consistency in all these aspects. So what we do basically is that we touch and inspect 100% of all the production that we make the previous day, but also we track the information who produced the cigars, how many cigars they produced, and the type of cigar, I mean the brand itself. And with this sticker we send it to the payroll, and the tobacco people get paid because of this sticker. Okay, so after we inspect the cigar, we insert them in boxes of cedar in order for us to keep it in the aging room and give the aging process of minimum of 3 weeks. Welcome to the money room.
The money room.
Yeah. This is the money room. We have here, in the process of giving the appropriate aging time, around 3 million cigars. So it means we have a lot of money in this room. This room, we call it the aging room of cigars, in order for us to give minimum of 3 weeks of aging time. With that time, we guarantee that our cigars get into the right condition to be packed, because we cannot pack cigars with moisture levels, because they could get contaminated with more problem or damage into the boxes. So the idea is that we dry them out a little bit, the cigar, and give the appropriate time for the cigar to get know each other, because we use certain amount of different tobacco types in every cigar. They don't know each other. So for them to get to know each other, we need to let them play in a cigar, okay? You're not gonna believe me, but every time I come in the morning to this room, I hear noises of the tobacco speaking one to each other, fighting one to each other, in order for them to get into an agreement, okay, before we smoke the cigar, before we light up the cigar. And also, the amount of ammonia in the morning also is very high, because this room spend the whole night with no ventilation. So they are releasing, the tobacco is breathing and liberating the excess ammonia that it has inside. So I invite you to come very early in the morning, around 6 o'clock in the morning, in order for you to experience, this historical, let's say, aspects of the tobacco and the cigars. But it is wonderful how the tobacco improve with the aging process. Kiko can tell you that how the tobacco improve with the aging process. Of course, we believe in aging. We do believe in aging. It's not the same when you are smoking a recent cigar being produced, a recent cigar, then you smoke a cigar after 3 to 4 weeks. So the tobacco talks, at the beginning, they don't get along together, but then when they get to know each other after 3 weeks, we have a perfect smoke, because it's a well-balanced cigar. And for us to have a well-balanced cigar, we need to use the appropriate tobacco and give the appropriate time to the aging process. In this area, we just keep the mild blends, especially the Macanudo, the Partagas, and Cohiba Regular. In the other room, we keep the stronger blends. Why we do that? Because the tobacco attract all the smell from the environment, okay? So the fuller body blends can also influence in the mild blends and distort the natural flavor of the tobacco, okay? So in this room, we keep stronger blend, like for example, Partagas Black Label, Cohiba Black, among others, and mostly the maduros, maduros cigar. If you can feel in this room, the smell of ammonia is a little bit higher, it's a little bit stronger, right? Any questions so far?
How many million cigars, how many cigars you say are in these aging rooms at one time?
We have here close to 2.4. We have another room with close to 700,000 cigars.
So it's about 3 million.
So in premium, we have around 3 million cigars. Right, Francisco?
Yep.
3 million cigars. Getting the appropriate aging time in order for us to then do the packing.
So three weeks for both rooms, cigars for 3 weeks.
3 weeks minimum.
Minimum.
There are some less sober cigars.
Less sober?
Probably have 1 year, 1.5 years, but minimum quantities. A special project that we developed 2 years ago, and we still keep it here. Your machine are faster.
Of course.
Cigar smaller. So this is the packing area.
What's up with the La Paulina?
What?
La Paulina back there on the table.
La Paulina? We are manufacturing cigars for them. Since last year. Yeah, La Paulina cigars. But let's talk about the processes. The processes started here. When we made a requirement to the in-room, the cigars that are ready to be packed, I mean the cigars that we already give the three weeks of aging process. We bring it here. So we conduct a process of shading. With this process, we guarantee that every box of cigar will carry the same tone of color. Okay? The idea is that we separate the same exact color in order for us to put the same color branch in every box of cigar. And also here you can find some defects, some minor defects due to the transportation or due to the handling of the product. But normally we have more capacity at this time than we need, because they can process more than 100,000 cigars per day. Okay? And let me introduce you also to Liliana, because our people is one of the most important assets that we have. She's Liliana. She entered the company when she was 18. So it means that she has more than 50 years.
5 years ago.
She has been with us for around 36 years, actually.
Wow.
36.
Congratulations.
Okay. She's 50 something. I don't want to tell you the peak, because I don't want to get into trouble, Liliana. You know, a lady is very jealous by saying her age. Thank you, Liliana. So after this process, we transfer the cigar to the packing area, where we bind, sell, apply UPC stickers, and insert the cigar into every box, okay? We work with lean manufacturing. It means that we have a decent flow, a nice flow of packaging. So what we do basically is one person bind the cigar, the other person insert the cigar into a cellophane, and the other person apply the UPC stickers and insert the cigar in the boxes. And of course, we have a quality control person that inspect every box that comes out of these processes. The idea is that we work in flow in order for us to keep quality control and to speed up the process. Also, we improve dramatically in the yield of the process. As we used to have a traditional flow where we have a bunch of people binding the cigar, a bunch of people cellophaning, and a bunch of people also introducing the cigar into the boxes. But then, a few years, few years before we changed to this method, and of course it has been paying off because we have a more a fast flow. We can identify if there is a quality issue right away, immediately, because every person become a quality inspector from the previous one. So she can see a defect that maybe by inserting the cigar into a cellophane tape.
So it could scratch or crack the wrapper, putting it in there, yeah.
So we can process correct, or we can take correct actions immediately instead of wait one day when we used to wait with the previous method of packing.
Well, it's consistent if you have one person doing all of the cellophaneing, one person doing all the bands, right? You get consistent because different people do it slightly differently.
So correct. Yeah. And they get to high speed because of the practice.
Yeah.
The practices improve the processes. And also, these processes help us to be more flexible in changes, because here you can work one brand, particular brand, and in the other flow, you can work with other brands. It's more flexible to changes. We have a lot of variety of different packaging methods. We have cigars in tin, cigar in cello tube, cigar in crystal tube, cigar in aluminum tube. So we have a lot of familiars of products that it's not easy for us to track and to keep the consistency. But by doing this, we improve this process dramatically. Also, as we are using UPC in every cigar, we scan some of them randomly in order for us to see if we are applying the right UPC to every cigar and if the UPC can be read. That is another problem. Can you imagine if our UPC cannot be read? So you will have, retailer will have problems at the store.
Get closer.
Okay, this is the final packing where we wrap the boxes. We produce also, we make bundles of 10 or 5 cigars or 20 or 20, depending on the requirement. So this is the final, when we apply final also labels like guarantee sales, like suggestion warning, among others. So after this process, so we send all the bosses to this department in order for us to fill the shipping carton with boxes of cigars. Instead of using any chemical that can affect the health of our consumers, we do the deep freezing. So we insert the cigars in this cooler for at least 5 days. In 2 days, the temperature gets to minus 20 Fahrenheit. Then with 2 more days at that temperature, any human being, any box that is inside of the process of cigar, which we got to the cigar, must be dead. Okay? So we turn off the equipment in day 4 and we wait 1 more day in order for the temperature to get high and get uniform with the temperature outside in order to avoid condensation of the cigars. Because the cigar, if you take out the cigar with that temperature, the cigar must get wet. And you have a quality issue, okay? So we have like 7 coolers like this.
Oh, wow.
7. Here we have one. In the bottom we have 2 more. And in other areas, for example, machine areas, we have 2 more. So we have like 7 coolers inside.
Okay, this used to be Paulino Delgado's office. Paulino Delgado was a boss master maker. He produced most of these beautiful pieces of wood. These beautiful masterpieces. He produced most of these. And Paulino Delgado was a former employee from General Cigar that worked with General Cigar for 46 years. He's a Puerto Rican guy that retired a few years before. But this was his office. This is filled with boxes that he produced.